Thank you. Thank you. I understand back in Missouri that you had some fiddler uncles.
That's right. I had all 6 or 7 uncles that fiddled. Dad's oldest brother, I guess, was about one of the best fiddlers. His name was Watt Hughey, and his son, they both played. We used to go see him about once a year and, you know, and fiddle, and I really enjoyed that when I was a kid.
You had an Uncle Ed, was he, didn't you?
Yeah, that was Uncle Ed. About all he ever done in the winter was stand around the stove and chew tobacco and fiddle. Of course, he eat, too, pretty good, once in a while, about every 30 minutes. And then he carried his money right up, you know, and he kept it in the backer sack up in his overhaul, pinned in there with a safety pin.
Right.
Quite a guy.
Yeah. You know, there's one thing I noticed, you talking about the fiddlers of today that are really much better than the old-timers, you thought.
Oh, yeah, I think so, because in them days, you see, they never learned no new tunes hardly ever on account of... The only way they could learn a new tune was somebody come through the country, you know, new, and he'd have a tune you didn't have. Maybe you would hear it once, and then that would be the end of it, you see, till... And maybe you get it halfway right, maybe you wouldn't.
You learned from people like Len Dawsey and the Crocketts, you said?
Yeah, right.
Len Dawsey, was he with the... What band was he with?
Well, Stuart Hamlin, the Arizona Wranglers. And
well, the Crocketts, was that the Mountaineers?
Yeah, Kentucky Mountaineers.
You know, I remember an old tune that my brother picked up off an old 78 Crockett record called Kitty Kai.
Right, I play it.
That's... Then there's, I've noticed there's an awful lot of new tunes that I haven't heard, and I've been around fiddlers all my life. Where'd you get them?
Oh, I picked them up back there in the east from my uncles.
Like Yellow Gal and F&D. And
yeah, that's been the family for years, this Yellow Gal. That's the only place I ever heard it.
Sally in the Garden?
Right.
There's I heard you talking to some fellows out there about a silk thread bow or
something. Oh, yeah, one winter I run out of hair in my bow back there, and of course snow was on, you had to go in a horse and buggy or wagon. The town is about 7.5 miles, and you didn't go very often, so I made me a bow out of silk thread, and it worked good, too.
You know, I heard you tell somebody out here about this little fiddle that you had. I noticed there's a hole in the back. What does that mean?
Oh, I used to wear overhauls, you know, and that's what scratched the back of that fiddle so bad.
That's the first fiddle you ever had?
Right. Holy bull.
Say, I got an idea. Why don't we take that fiddle and you play the first tune you ever played on it? What was it?
Well, that's Wagnor.
Okay, you think we could do it?
Sure. Let's go.